How's it going, internets? I hope you're having a wonderful day today. It's time to get creative, it's time to animate, it's time to get imaginative, and it's time to get inspired. And today's inspiration is one of my favorite illustrators and animators for that right of all time, and that is Jamie Hewlett. If you're not familiar with Tank Girl, perhaps you're familiar with the gorillas. He is the illustrator and one of the main two creators, the more visual creator of that band as well. Man, he's great. His line work, just check out those amazing lines, the expression he gets in his character. I've got over there, let me see, up a little more, over here. A nice little illustration that I grabbed off of his, and we'll just take a better look at this, but just look at those expressions that he can get. He really knows how to still stay true to form, and you know, solid. You can feel like there's a structure behind that, that there's like bones and flesh and all that stuff, but really exaggerate those expressions in a great, amazing way. Wow. Yeah, I could stare at his stuff for hours. I've been wanting to talk about him for a long time. Unfortunately, not all of his stuff, at least in the Tank Girl genre, is super safe for work, so I'm trying to... So beware, those of you who are younger, that you might want to get your parents' permission if you can before you grab a copy of this as well. But definitely check out any of his illustrations with the gorillas. It's great, and from what I hear, they're actually gonna do some more work as well, which is exciting because they haven't been done too much in a while. So anyways, here's a quote that I grabbed for him, which I think is just superb, and I don't know that I have anything more that I could add to it behind besides just what he says. So it's about reaching that moment of pure ecstasy when a drawing just happens, where every move you make with your hand and every thought you have in your head grows in front of you without any mistakes. No rubbing out, starting again, and getting frustrated. It's like being in a trance. It's fluid, and you almost don't remember doing the picture. Drawing is an escape from all unnecessary things in life that get in the way of being free. Ugh, it's just... I'm gonna take a second and... People don't really do this on YouTube, but we're going to take like a moment of silence and just envelop that quote. Okay. I know I normally don't do that. That's kind of weird, but I think it's just really important to try and get that in your work, that almost trance-like feel to where it's just going. You're not... You know, your thoughts aren't in the way hindering you, you're not distracted, your muscles are loose and you can do the work you need to do, your thoughts are clean, your idea is solid enough, and it just comes together. And I think that's what we all, as creatives in whatever field you are really striving for, that moment, those moments in your creating when they just happen, and it's almost like you weren't... It's kind of strange, but it's almost like you weren't even there for it. It just happened through you. You're the vessel channeling that stuff. And I think that's why you practice and you work at it to get past the mechanics of whatever it is that your creative field has, to getting into that point where the creative spirit just goes through you and goes from your original idea or thought and then out onto whatever medium, paper or the website or movies or music or whatever it is. So as you're working today, just try and think about what you can do to help get you to that point, or just keep practicing whatever it is so that you know that eventually that will happen for you. And it doesn't happen every day, you know. Even real professionals in any field will tell you they have like off days where it just isn't connecting for some reason, but that's why we practice and that's why we do stuff every day. So I hope that you guys stay inspired and stay challenged and stay motivated to go for that. So that being said, let's get into today's work. If you're not familiar with this series, what we do is I usually will go scour the web to find a free rig that you can download. This is a Teddy rig. I've never used this rig before. It's available from simplymaya.com. I believe I have that correct. Let me check here. Yep, simplymaya.com. It's a free rig you can download. With this one, you do have to register for their site in order to download it, but it's still free for you. I've never used this rig. With these videos, we usually give ourselves anywhere from like 45 minutes to 2 hours, depending on the rig, depending on the idea, depending on any sort of challenges that we come up with. And we give ourselves 48 frames to try and get creative. That's 2 seconds, which seems kind of short, but in animation, doing 2 seconds is can be make or break your scene and can really give that sense of life to something. And it's something that's achievable to do every day and share with you guys as well. So don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you do enjoy these videos, and definitely throw down in the comments if there's different rigs you want to try or different kind of animation scenes you want to see, or if there's different things you want to talk about or different artists to look at or any of that kind of stuff. Any sort of thoughts, ideas, comments, critiques, concerns, any kind of stuff. This is really trying to be kind of a community-based channel from what I can do to bring up ideas and talk about things, and sometimes just talk through them myself as well. So hopefully you guys get something out of this for more really polished and professional animators, which I'm sure you all are better animators than me. Maybe you can just get inspired to keep creating and keep going every day, or come up with some different ideas from talking about this, or just get those creative juices flowing. And for new people to animation, maybe you can learn a couple things or try out something different than maybe you had before. So without further ado, let's get into it. Let's go ahead, and first thing I do is usually create a polygon primitives cube, just so we have a base with which to work with. And I'm gonna hit 5 on the keyboard to turn our textures off, just so our rig's a little bit lighter. And let's go ahead and get started. I did switch the hands to FK instead of being an IK, because I figured that would be probably a little bit better for the... It's usually what I work with. I tend to like it a little bit better for walks. But if you're doing, like, let's see, something like this, where I'm leaning my elbow or putting my hand flat on a surface or something like this, definitely keep it in IK so that you can really get that solid flat or a stationary position or weight or whatever it is that you're trying to sell. It's a lot easier in IK than in FK. But if you're doing big moves like a run or a jump or anything like that, keeping stuff in FK helps the continuity of the body to flow from the movement of like the chest to the shoulders to the arms to the hands, and it helps keep that solid there. And let's go ahead and rotate the feet out a little bit. This looks like a fun rig to use. It's a little bit of an older rig. I think this one was done in 2007. I haven't really seen too many people use this rig, so I've been trying to, when I can, when I have time, find rigs that aren't necessarily ones that are used all the time. So I was kind of thinking with this one, if we can get it to kind of just holding one arm, doing a little chin tap for the walk, just to add like kind of a little bit of thought in the expression or thought, if we could. But these hands are pretty big, so I don't know if we'll be able to do that idea as well as I would have thought we could. But we'll see if we can't get it here. Unfortunate, we don't have a way to do each and every bit of the finger, but that's okay. I think we can still get it to work. Just want to try and get a good character storytelling pose here if we can, to start us off, so we get some character built into our shot right away. And I'll take that over. still want to try and get a good silhouette out of everything if we can here as well. But we're just seeing if this will work with those big hands, if we can get them to get into the positions that we want here. And normally, I don't use the big controllers too much. I try to do it with sticking to just rotate X, just rotate Y, and just rotate Z rather than doing that universal one. But sometimes, depending on the rigs and everything, you need to get in there and get that pose exactly as you want. Sometimes rotate X or rotate Y, you have to blend them together to get that posing that you want. And don't be afraid to do that. It's just a little bit simpler, I think, to if you can keep it separated. We got big feet here, so we're not going to be able to do too big a step, so that's going to feel too forced. And let's see. It's kind of got a Seven Dwarfs-ish feel to this character, which is kind of nice. I like. Fingers, but we'll do with what we got. As I've talked about before, and I'm not going to tell that story again just because I tell it, I feel like I think I've told it twice now. I don't want to keep repeating myself, but when, instead of giving up on an idea, or if your rig doesn't necessarily have a certain thing or whatever, just keep in mind the James Baxter story that I shared with you guys a little while ago about put a bucket in front of it, just or in the Bula Robello Yoda terms, do or do not. There is no try. It either works or it doesn't. Trying is, I don't know, I guess that's a little harsh, but if it doesn't work, it doesn't matter how much you tried or didn't try. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Okay. Let's see. Guess we could do a little bit of. What's the head? They have a neck controller here. Yeah, there's the neck. A little bit of rotate. Is there like a jaw or any sort of facial controls that we get with this rig? Be nice if there's some sort of jaw. Let's see, maybe it's in the head controller. No. It's show none, nerve curves. Nothing. Nerve surfaces and polygons. Let's turn our grid off. I feel like we need to push those hips a little bit more forward here as well. Just keep them balanced with the feet. Turn our textures back on, see what we got here. It's really strange. They have the tongue and everything, and the mouth, but no controls for them. Let's see. Maybe it's on the bottom here. Facial GUI. Turn it on. Here we go. Okay. I knew there had to be one somewhere here. It's the me move. Oh, that's just that. It's this mouth control. I guess we could pull it down like that. It's this one. Now, there's an interesting Animation Mentor put out a nice little video a little bit ago about where, oh goodness gracious, now I can't think of who it was, but the mentor there talked about eyelids. And he brought up some good points, which were refreshers for me from what I learned when I was in school as well. Is to be careful with eyelids, that you don't want them to seem too sleepy. So you have to try to find a good balance of bottom eyelid. Usually it's not too much. Most of the eyelid movement's going to come from the top and not as much from the bottom. Okay, I feel like that's a okay starting pose. We can definitely tweak it, but it'll give us something to work with. It's got a little bit of character, so let's give us 48 frames with which to work with. Let's go ahead and turn that facial GUI off for right now, and let's go ahead and grab everything, go to frame one, and we'll set a key there. Okay, now let's start building our lock. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get the foundational stuff in there. So that's going to be pretty much the feet and the hips. And once we got those working, then we can go further from there. Okay, we'll set that at 12. And we'll go to 24. And I think for this one, we'll keep with our base 12 system for our steps. Some walks do a little bit slower, some a little faster. But I feel like this one will pretty much run at typical speed. And usually walks are anywhere from 11s to 13s. It's a good, like, average pacing for a not too fast, not too slow kind of a walk. Just an average human usually will walk around 11 frames or 13 frames per step. And we've got to make sure knees are getting wonky because we got the knee controllers not going forward, so we don't want to punch those forward there. It's fine. Let's see if we got the basic stuff down here. Yeah. Okay. Let's go into the hips and window animation editors, graph editor, and let's go to translate Z here, and let's even that out so there's a consistent, even amount of what left right movement. Or right to left, depending on which angle we're at. Just so those hips have a constant movement speed. And let's go ahead and get into some passing positions. So we're just gonna go ahead and key what we have there. Raise it up, and drag it back. And then it'll land here. So there's a little up, a little down, set there, raise it up, rotate it back. Might have to make those a little bit smaller too with those steps, because these are some big feet this character's got. My, what big feet you have! Is that Little Red Riding Hood? I don't know. That was like the worst female impression I think I've ever done in my life. I don't know if I should ever do impressions again on my channel. Let me know in the comments below how awful that was. That was pretty awful. Okay, I think we might need to do a little less rotate, because it feels like those feet are just dragging, like they're barely even picking up, even though they are. So let's do a little less rotate back. steps a little more as well. Okay, let's see here. Yeah, let's see if we can get some toe movement in there to really make this start to come alive here. Toe. So set the toe of 12. Rotate it back. I got the Y's working where I would normally say the X's would be. And this is a translate instead of a rotate, which is kind of funky, but that's okay. Use what you got. And so we have. And come on. So we have 36. Down here and raise it back up. That's alright, let's clean it up a little more here. Oh, I accidentally keyed something off there that we didn't need to. I feel like it's just a little too much movement. Since the feet are so big, even small movements on there are definitely going to seem large with this one, because the feet are like as big as the whole chest, really. Before we go and do the other foot, I want to get some up and down in those hips. Just because it's distracting me for some reason today. It doesn't always, but the hips aren't working before I get the feet working. Usually I like to get the hips working first and then go in and do the touch up on the feet, but the feet are so large on this one that it's funky. This the translate X is actually what I would normally associate with the translate Y, is the up and down, but for some reason on this rig it's different, but that's okay. Just roll with it. So let's see. Okay, that's at least something better. Okay, now we'll get into this other foot here. And what do we want to do? The toe move. Okay, so I'll drag it back there, lift it up here, and zero it out there. Go 24. Key selected, key selected. And I'll drag it down there, lift it up here. And zero it out again. Let's go clean that up. Anyway, hit some keys on translate Z. I saw that going on. Gotta clean that up. Let's see. Okay, let's get a little sway in the hips going. Lean him over that planted foot, and that planted foot, that planted foot, and that planted foot, and back again. Set the translate Y for some reason, and zero it out. And let's clean up those curves a little more. Might be too much, we might scale it back, we'll see. And let's do a little bit of rotate. So we rotate Z just so it favors that planted foot here. And pull it back here. And the head's tilting for that too. It's kind of funny. Okay, I'll go ahead and clean that up in a little bit though. Let's do a little rotate X to favor this foot planted, and to favor that foot. Okay, let's see. Definitely a little too much movement in those hips for right now, but it's getting there. So let's go ahead and scale everything back a little bit. Let's just go back remember, when you're animating, it's not necessarily important to have exact values. Like, it doesn't have to be 2.944 and have that match up exactly when you're animating, but you just want to get those feel, the feeling there. Oh, my voice is a little scratchy today. Sorry about that. And let's get in here and do a little bit of rotate Z, just to offset the movement from, so we got a little bit of squash, a little bit of stretch there. And same on this side. This is going to balance out the movement that we put in the hips. He's kind of got Shrek ears from the back, getting a very Shrek vibe there. And do a little bit so that the arms are favoring the opposite of the planted foot, forward foot. So let's see if that's working. Might be a little much, so maybe we'll scale it back a little bit. Let's see, rotate Z. Because all the feeling of the movement's good, it's just a little over-exaggerated right now. And if that's what we were going for this shot, that'd work fine, but I think we want to keep the those movements to a minimum, because I think we want the focus to be kind of like that he's concentrating or thinking. We'll do a little chin tap kind of a thing going. Since we don't have as many finger controls, that's going to be a little bit harder to sell than I anticipated. That's okay. And the other thing, though, is I do feel like the the hips are a little unbalanced, so I'm going to push those forward a little bit more, and maybe a little bit more here, just a little. Let's turn our textures back on so we can kind of see how it feels right there. And put the eyes forward just a little bit more. Bit of movement in those arms, but not a lot. I want to keep the main posing here. A little bit of rotate Y, a little bit of rotate back, a little bit forward, and a little bit back, just so those arms don't totally lock up there. And then we'll do a little bit of in here. So there's a little bit of movement there. And let's do a little bit in the hand as well. Back. And back. And up. And back. Might be a little too much in the hand here, which might mean that it's actually coming from the elbow that's too much, so we'll see if we need to, which one we need to approach. Let's do a little bit of movement in those fingers. So let's see. One second here. Okay, sorry about that. Where were we? much, so let's tone that down a lot. Let's see. This a little bit. Okay, now too much movement on that arm altogether. Let's go ahead and tone that down. Let's do maybe a little bit less here. So let's keep toning everything down a lot more. Because we really want the movement to come from the fingers themselves. This guy as well. Okay. Just little moves. And we can get most of the movement coming from the finger. Okay, let's see. There we go. That's a little bit better. Let's go ahead and do that middle sway a little bit down further. Let's see. It would be nice if we could get some overlap in the tips of that digit, but we'll go with what we got. And let's put it back about 2 frames. Let's see. stretch out is too long, so let's shorten those all down by a frame. Okay, let's see. Maybe it's just too far back. Alright, sorry about that. A lot of interruptions today at Turbo Studios. I don't know, I gotta come up with a better name for that. So I was able to find a different controller on the bass here that I think will allow us to get a little bit better movement in that finger, hopefully. We'll see here. Let's go back here and set a key there. And then rotate Z out there. And back there. Here. And back there. Out here. And back there. And then kind of hold it for a little bit more. Let's see. Starting to feel a little better. And let's go here. I think we're gonna wanna go with the elbow just to clear up that spacing there. And since we have these other digits, and since we can get into them a little bit more, I think that means that we can get a little bit better movement throughout there. So let's go ahead and set those on. Six. Go ahead and rotate it back. We'll kind of do a thump, a successive thump where it'll be finger, 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 finger. So kind of like a thump roll. There. let's take all the mids and tips. Let's go ahead and delay all those by a frame. I still think we need to tweak a little bit of the posing here. And delay those by a frame. So we want to go. Let's go ahead and tweak this up a little bit more. Let's give us one more frame per move. Tricky to grab these controllers, so let's make sure we're grabbing all the right stuff here. And delete that as a frame. Okay, let's turn our NURB curves off so we can actually see if that's working. Okay, so one thing I know right off the bat, what I want to do is I want to minimize the movement here on this finger. Because we don't need that one to be as big of movements there. Let's go ahead and watch that now. The movement on joint here. And I definitely want to increase the movement throughout on this guy here. So let's exaggerate that a little bit more. Let's see. Let's go ahead and delay all of this stuff by one more frame. Delay all of this by one more frame. Maybe there's not enough frame delay between the digit joints, just so we can get that nice. Still feels like it's all a little bit too fast. So let's just go one by one here. Let's give us one more frame, one more frame. hits. One more frame before that hits. Let's do the same on this one. Let's grab everything, delete a frame, grab everything there, delete a frame, grab everything here, delete a frame, there, delete that a frame, and delete that a frame. Now let's go watch it. Second here, something's going on outside. Man, it's like land of a thousand distractions here at the local studio. But that's okay. Just try and keep focused and keep going. And let's see here. Delay that a frame. Delay that a frame. Let's go ahead and shrink that back down again and just raise this part up again. So let's see. It's kind of looking more like it should. Let's go ahead and turn that hat off though. That kind of weird cheek thing that was going on. Okay, let's go ahead and grab this guy. Tip of this finger of the mid isn't working as well as I would have liked, so let's go ahead and just change that up a little bit. And let's go ahead and grab this and put the middle sway up a little bit more and the ring sway up a little bit more. And pinky, I could probably pull it out a little bit more. So much sway in that head here, so let's go ahead and sway that we have in the head from the hips there. A little bit of, I guess this is rotate X on this rake. Not a lot, but just a little bit. Maybe that'll tone that head down and keep it kind of a little more focused forward. Let's see if that worked here. Switch over the other direction here. Let's see. There we go. Let's try a little bit of, I think that was in the head, so let's do the neck here. There, rotate there. I mean, we don't want to lock it off, but we definitely want to. Some rotate Y. No, let's rotate X here. That doesn't do anything. Bummer. Okay. Well, let's see what we can do here. Let's get back into the head. We can just push it over a little bit. Normally I just stick with the rotates rather than translates on the head, because usually that looks a little off, so we'll see. Okay. Little goes a long way with that too, so let's see. Definitely too much over this way, so let's go ahead and squash that down a little bit. Let's see here. Maybe we'll do it on the 12s here. I feel like this is going to be too much. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, just go ahead and get rid of that. just fix it maybe with the rotate here. Would that be rotate X? Maybe just a little less side to side in the chest. We'll clear that up here. Let's see. Maybe we'll do it in the hips a little less. We'll get it out of there eventually, whether it's in the hips or the chest or the head. Okay, neither of those did it, so let's see. So another thing we could do is, let's see, do this instead. Boop. Just plant that hand right where we want it. Readjusting this shot a little more. Really was thinking this one was going to be pretty straightforward, but that's okay. It's never as straightforward when you think it's going to be easy, right? Too far. Well, one thing that we can easily do is just do this and zero it out, and we should still have everything that we had before. Okay. Yeah, that's way better. That one's not gonna work as well. It's just the head tips. Okay. So I'm gonna get rid of the rotate in the hips and the chest. Let's see if we can't figure out where this problem's going for. If you ever have troubles, don't be afraid to zero your stuff out. We'll keep our initial pose, but we'll just definitely get rid of some of that. And that should keep our... let's see. This hand should be the other way around. Okay, let's minimize what we have here in the elbow. It's funny, when you get rid of animation or go back to a simpler version, you notice stuff that you didn't maybe in the other one. Like this arm wasn't as... Now let's do a little bit of finger moves here. So index basement, we'll curl it in a little bit here, and we'll pull it out a little bit there, pull it in a little bit here, just have a little bit of like a grip kind of feel into that, just so it's supporting that other hand. Let's see if we can't get a little bit of that movement in the hips back like we had before. Just a little bit. And we'll do it step by step this way, so we make sure that we get one and then the other polished up before we go on. And that's a good way to approach stuff too. When you can't find it, like you think there might be a problem in the hand, but really it's in the forearm, or it's in the upper arm, or it's really coming from the chest, this move, and you're fighting with the finger move, but really it's a problem in the upper body and it's going out through it. So sometimes it's good to just zero that stuff out, just to find the origin point. Let's go do a little bit here, a little bit there, a little bit here, a little bit there, and back again. Okay, that seems like too much, so we'll definitely scale that back a lot. Let me do some eyebrow controls. Alright, cool. I got to film those. And let's pull that one down. And one good thing that you like to try and do with eyebrows is to get a nice flow throughout the eyebrow. So we want it to feel like it's one universal curve between there. as well go this and that and that. Not as much. So we'll kind of switch with all. Let's go ahead and raise this up even more. So we're going to set that there. Set that there. Do kind of a little expression change since the body isn't doing as well as I was hoping it would. So we'll go ahead and four, and we'll set that to like 16, so we hold that first expression a little bit longer, and then take what we have at 46 and hold that at like 35, so we hold that, so both of the and maybe about two frames for each. So I'll push those forward a frame, and these ones back a frame so they kind of follow, and let's lead with this eyebrow, so that one is going to be forward two frames, and let's watch that now. Here too is where the eyelids are, and there's some facial expression. Yeah, okay, let's go ahead and save our file, control S, and let's see if we can't get back into face GUI on. I think there's one that was like an eyelid. What about the eyes? Darn, it's just a left and right control. What's that? Oh, that's the jaw. That actually might be fun to kind of do a little bit with. Do a little, so it's like, sorry about that. Let's grab this. Let's hold that first move, so it holds for a little bit longer. I'm gonna minimize the amount of movement and set that key there. And hold it back and shorten the duration of those moves as well. So let's try that. Since we don't have an upper lid for each one, let's go ahead and grab upper and lower, and we'll set those there. And then let's pull that down and have it meet a little bit up here. And then go back to what do we have, like frame two there, set that at 48, so there's a little bit of blink in that expression change. Definitely want to hold the eyes open for longer, and I'm okay with taking a little while for them to reopen. I think that adds a little bit of character as well, but we don't want to could have the mustache kind of do a little bit of squash on this side and stretch on that side. So the whole face, the mustache and the other eyebrow are kind of squashing it down. That'll add a little bit more feeling of rubberiness to that face. Or fleshiness, whichever way you want to go. I think those moves are a little too much on the jaw. So let's go ahead and minimize that stuff a little bit more. Okay, let's do a little bit in the chest now, because I don't think we went back and redid that since we deleted it. So let's go ahead and rotate Z. A little bit here, a little bit there. We'll probably have to minimize this, because this is probably where we're getting a lot of that movement from that we didn't like before. So we're definitely gonna keep that to a minimum here. But I think it's important to still try and get that in there so you have that kind of compression throughout the chest here. Okay, let's go ahead and check that out now. Let's try to get some of that side-to-side movement that we had before. Now with that. Let's clean that, those curves up a little bit. Rotate X, rotate X. Okay, let's see. Okay, go and save that. Let's see if we can get a little bit of compression in here. So a little bit of back, a little bit forward, a little bit forward, a little bit of back. And let's clean that curve up here. Just so there's a little bit of compression in there and feeling of that it's fleshy in there as well. Okay, that feels okay. I think we could exaggerate it a little bit more, but I'm not sure that need to, but maybe I might revisit it and exaggerate it a little bit more. Let's see. They have, oh, I thought maybe those are ear controls, but they're just the brow controls, but I think we've got the brow working all right. Let's see. I wonder if we could do just a teensy bit of translate here. Just a little bit. Oh, you know what? Didn't do, we need to set our key here at 1 first. Go back. And this is not be a lot, just to add a little bit of flavor and texture to that spine movement by mixing it up a little bit. So let's see. See, there's a little bit of swing to those hips now that wasn't there before. Okay. I feel like that works pretty well. Do a little better job of evening that out, though. Okay, let's try it now. Yeah, that feels a little better. Let's take what we have there, set that, give us like 4 frames of kind of a hold. And that might read a little better, so it actually goes up, back, up, back. I'll set that, and I'll give a few more frames. Six, set that there. 38, put that to 40. Just so we get that little bit of rest in between there. Make it feel like it's really just landing. High on those. keep tweaking with it or not? Let's watch the console. On that the thumb sway so that it feels like it's holding a little bit more. Maybe they'll do a little bit of thumb sway here as well. And then we'll delay that by a couple of frames so that it's not hitting on the same thing. I feel like that works all right. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Things you might have done differently, or different approaches or different ideas, or if you do a little short or an animation, if you end up using this rig, definitely share it back so we can talk about it and see all the amazing stuff that you're up to. Before we finish this, let's go ahead and save our file. Let's turn our NURB curves off. I wanted to scale this back a little bit more so we might get some better silhouette there. And let's go ahead and pop that back to frame one. Okay, and let's go ahead and watch it there. One thing I was kind of thinking as we go forward is that I want this to hit a little bit sooner. Let's really take what we have there. And have like 45, at like 39. So yeah. Let's have this guy go down a little bit faster. Since like almost pressure pushing that other eyebrow up. Let's go ahead and scale this a little bit bigger. Turn our curves on. All right, I think that works okay. So let me know down in the comments below if you have any sort of ideas, thoughts, comments, critiques, anything. If you end up liking this rig, if you haven't seen it before, definitely go check it out. Before we close up, though, let's go ahead and kind of recap where we started with today's inspiration. It's about reaching that moment of pure ecstasy when a drawing just happens, where every move you make with your hands and every thought you have in your head grows in front of you without any mistakes. No rubbing out, starting again, and getting frustrated. It's like being in a trance. It's a fluid, and you almost don't remember doing the picture. Drawing is an escape from all the unnecessary things in life that get in the way of being free. I think that's a great way. I mean, it's evident just in the video today. There were a bunch of little distractions going on in the background for myself, so I noticed that I was kind of not able to focus as much. And as soon as I was able to eliminate those, started coming together. And that's the one thing with your work, you know. Even though I love to listen to music and I love to multitask and have a bunch of windows open, I find that when I'm really in that zone, really creating, all that stuff kind of fades away, whether it means that I turn it off or I just kind of zone that out. I don't know, just kind of how I work, and I think it is a better way to start getting to those creative moments in life. So that being said, thanks again for watching. Thanks for liking the videos and subscribing to the channel. You guys are awesome. You're amazing. You're all wonderful, creative folks, and I appreciate watching and sharing this creative journey that we're all on with you guys. Well, that being said, I hope you guys have a great night. Thanks again, and we'll see you tomorrow for some more animation.